So before going to the concurrent schedule, I just want to tell you the execution of all the serial schedule always keeps the database in a consistent state. Now in your examination, they may ask you a question like this. Execution of serial schedule always keeps your database in a consistent set. Is this statement is true or false? If it is true, justify your answer by giving suitable example. So this question may be asked for 10 marks. You can consider any serial schedule the way we have seen in schedule number 1 and schedule number 2. Let us consider the same example of schedule 1, where we have two transactions. One transaction is transferring 50 rupees from account A to account B, whereas another transaction is transferring 10% of the amount from account A to account B. Let us solve this example and let's check whether this schedule keeps our database in a consistent state or not. To check that, so before performing the transaction T1, your transaction T1, find out A plus B is the balance account in A and balance in account B. Consider the initial balance in account A as rupees 1000 and in account B as rupees 2000. By considering this, before performing transaction P1, I can say that what is there in account A and account B is 10,000 rupees plus 2,000. Total goes to 3,000 rupees, right? Let us complete now the instruction given into transaction T1. Now what I want is you open your notebook and take pen. Simultaneously, you also perform this in your notebook. If I perform read A operation in transaction T1, what I am going to get, students, here, when I perform read operation on A, I will get the answer as 1000 because in accounting that is 1000 rupees. Then I am going to perform another statement, that is A equal to A minus 50. Correct. So here in transaction T1, when I write read A, the value would be 1000. Then I write A equal to A minus 50, the value goes to 1000 minus 50 and it would be 950, correct? Then I perform write operation on account A. And this value gets updated into account A. After performing write A operation in account A, the value in account A balance would be 950. So we completed three statements, read A, A equal to A minus 50, then write A. Now we were going into account B, there we are performing read B operation. So what I'm going to get here, read B, the result would be 2000 rupees, right? And then when I write B equals to B plus 50, B plus 50, so it goes to 2000 plus 50 and final result would be 2050. It is temporarily calculated but not updated into account B. So the final statement is going to actually update that balance into account B. When I write B, 2050 gets stored into account B's balance. So this is the last statement of the transaction T1, right? Transaction T1. So now we completed all the statements from transaction T1. Let us see, after performing, this was the first statement and this was the last statement. We have to focus only on the updated balance, 950, and in account B it is 2050. After performing transaction T1, let us again check what is there in A plus B. Find out the sum of balances of account A and account B. It is 950 in account A now plus 2050 in account B, and again it goes to, total goes to 3000. So it means that if you see this statement, before performing the transaction T1 and after performing the transaction T1, the sum of balances of account A and account B are same, and because of these I can say that transaction T1 keeps the database in a consistent set. But whether the complete schedule, that is S1, keeps the database in a consistent state or not, that is to be checked now. So I will now take transaction T2. All the segments of transaction T2 I will check for consistency of transaction T2. So before, here I am writing, before performing transaction T2, let us see what is the sum of balances of account A and account B. A plus B equals to 950 is there in account A, plus in account B is 2050, and total value is 3000 rupees before performing transaction T2. You can check this into the schedule. So till now, if I only check A plus B, I will get 950 plus 2050 and that goes to 3000. Let us start executing the instruction of transaction T2 now. Here you are applying read A operation. The first operation is read A. So what you are going to get here, it is 950. And what you are going to do, the next statement here is, you want to find the 10% of the account A and store it into temporary variable. Temp equal to A into 0.10, and that goes to 950 into 0.10, and that would be 95 rupees. Our third statement in transaction T2 is, now subtract A equal to A minus temp. Subtract temp variable from the balance of account A. So I'll write A equal to A minus temp. It is the third line. So what is A? 950 minus 95. So it goes to, let's calculate this. 950 minus 95. Total value is 855 in my balance. 855 rupees remain. And then you update account A. So updated balance of account A would be 855 now. Let us see the next segment from transaction T2. It is read B. If I perform read B operation here, it will show me 2050 in the account B's balance. Then I am going to add temp value into account B, 10% value of account A to account B. So B equal to B plus temp, that goes to 2050 plus 855, and find the result. Let us calculate again. 855 is already there in the calculator. Now I am adding
2095.
Sorry, it's 95. Sorry, it's 95. Correct. So I'll subtract 95 here. In this step, I will subtract 95 from this account. Sorry, I will add 95 into B's account. So it goes to 2050 plus 95. 2050 plus 95. Right. And the total goes to 2145. 2145 rupees into account B. Let us update it into account B. Write B operation. And the total value is now in account B is 2145. So it means that we completed all the segments, all the instructions from transaction T2. Right? Let us check now. After performing, or you can say, after performing from account, after performing transaction T2, what is the sum of balances of account A and account B? Let us add this, A plus B. What is the updated value of account A? It is 855. What is the updated value of account B? It is 2145. Let us add it. Add this. 855 plus 2145. And let us calculate in the calculator. It must be 3000. 2145 is already there in the calculator. I am going to add 855 into it. And total value is 3000. So A plus B total goes to 3000. Now let us check again. Before performing the transaction T2, what was the balances in A plus B? The balance was 3000 rupees. And after performing transaction T2 also, the sum of balances of account A and account B is 3000. So it means that the transaction T2 also keeps your database in a consistent state. If the sum of balances are matching, the transactions T1 and T2 keeps the database in the consistent state. Why it is? It is because I checked for transaction T1. Before transaction T1, the balance of account A and account B was 3000. And after performing the transaction T1, again I checked what was the balance of in account A and account B. That is matching 3000. Both the side, it is matching, right? So that's why I can say that transaction T1 keeps my database in a consistent state. Similarly, I check it for transaction T2. I have executed all the instructions from transaction T2, and again I found before performing the transaction T2, the sum of balances were 3000. But after performing the transaction T2, again I found that the sum of balances is 3000 rupees. Then I can say that transaction T2 also keeps the database in a consistent state. Now coming to the final conclusion, is the schedule 1 that we have seen in the PDF here, is this schedule S keeps your database in a consistent state or not? That is to be checked now. So to answer this particular question, I must check the consistency for each and every transaction that are happening in this particular schedule. There are two transactions are executing concurrently into this, serially into this schedule. Because if you see why this is called a serial schedule, because all the instructions of T1 are executed and then later on T2's instruction started. So T1 is executed first and T2 later on. So it is example of serial schedule. And our job is to check whether the serial schedule keeps the database in a consistent state or not. That we are checking. And answer this particular question, that is the schedule 1 keeps the database in a consistent state or not? We have to check all the transactions, consistency for all the transactions. And we found that both the transaction T1 and T2 are keeping the transaction in a consistent state. Then we can write our final conclusion that after checking for all the transactions, we can say that the schedule S1, the schedule 1 keeps the database in a consistent set. Right? This is the final conclusion. Okay, this type of question may be asked for 10 marks. They may give you one schedule and ask you whether this particular schedule keeps your database in a consistent state or not, then you have to check for all the transactions that are happening into the schedule. If the values are not mentioned, then by default you can assume any balances in account A and account B. The way I assumed here, in account A 1000 rupees, in account B it is 2000 rupees balance. Then before performing the transaction, calculate the balance. After performing the transaction, again calculate the balance. If they match, then you can say that transaction T1 keeps the database in a consistent state. Then similarly, look for transaction T2, find the balances, sum of balances in account A and account B. Similarly, go to transaction T2, execute all the transaction instructions from T2, and then after performing T2, again find sum of balances in account A and B. If they are also matching before and after, then we can say that transaction T2 also keeps your database in a consistent state. And ultimately, if all the transactions keeps the database in a consistent state, then we can say that the schedule also keeps the database in a consistent state. That is the conclusion of our problem. Now,